Mr. Skhosana, thank you so much for joining us this morning. It's a sad morning, isn't it?
Good morning, and good morning, South Africa. It's a sad moment. We've lost a real business icon, a veteran, a stalwart, and a founder of Nafcoc. Dr. Richard Maponya has really been exemplary. We pass our condolences to the family and to all the people of South Africa, particularly the members of Nafcoc and the black business community. It is really a sad moment. We have lost a person who was really a leader, not only a leader, but a leader in action. And he has done a lot for South Africa. But we must also thank God that Maponya lived for quite a long time, 99 years. It's not an easy journey for everybody. Mm. But we must say that we are blessed as South Africans. And may his soul rest in peace.
Mr. Skhosana, the fact that he was the founding president of Nafcoc back in 1964 speaks volumes about the fact that he was a visionary, wasn't he?
Yes. Remember when, at the dark days of apartheid, when black people were not allowed to make business, Dr. Maponya and the other founders of Nafcoc saw it fit to start a movement to try and liberate black business. At that time, it wasn't an easy. In fact, you know, I was reading an article that when they went to launch the Nafcoc, there were only a convoy of 14 cars that could participate in the parade. So really, we have made some strides since then. And I think we are very proud of Dr. Maponya and his leadership.
If he looks looking at Nafcoc now, was he proud of Nafcoc as it stands today?
Well, looking at Nafcoc as it stands, really we are very happy. In reality, we think Dr. Maponya's leadership have inspired many people, because you now have quite a number of black business people, and Nafcoc now, at least you when Nafcoc started. It was terrible times. You couldn't even have an office. But at least now Nafcoc has got offices nationally. Nafcoc can be able to speak. Although the issues are slightly different now, the Nafcoc of Dr. Maponya and the Nafcoc of now are almost two different distinct organizations.
Yes. Now, Dr. Mr. Skhosana, speak to us about just his work ethic, which is something I think many South Africans need to emulate to a certain extent, because at the age of 87, Dr. Richard Maponya, he was launching the Richard Maponya Institute at the age of 87. You know, he still had the wherewithal to do something of that nature at that age of 87.
At the age of 87, I still remember there was a discussion at the age of 75 within the business circles. The discussion was about retirement. And I still remember that Dr. Maponya refused to retire. You know, his work ethics shows that he was really worried about the country. And he was really concerned about development. He was passionate. You know, Dr. Maponya, after becoming the president of Nafcoc, he never stayed and did nothing. When he launched the institute, when he started at the very late age working towards the development of the shopping malls like Maponya malls. But remember, at the very, very early age, he was also a businessman, passionate. So he's just a good example to follow of business people. And he was never controversial, not involved in any conflicts. Sometimes you read about business leaders doing funny things, and nowadays you hear issues of corruption and so on. He was a clean businessman.
Yes.
We really appreciate his leadership. We wish that South Africa could imitate him and do everything that Dr. Maponya worked. This thing of retirement, people at the old age wanting to sit down, doesn't work, particularly for this country. When the economy is in such dire straits, in fact, South Africans should now be working more and be prepared to work more for less. South Africans should the work ethics must change. Instead of talking about all these other things and hate speech, we should just be concentrating in what do we do with our problems of the country. And we appreciate that Dr. Maponya, at his age, was still doing that.
All right. Thank you so much for speaking with us, Nafcoc Secretary General Sonyosi Skhosana, there about the legacy of the late Dr. Maponya, who passed away in the early hours of this morning at the age of 99.